Well, it's sort of about three families. There's two sisters, independent young sisters, the Schlegels, the Wilcox family, which I'm a part of, I'm Evie Wilcox, and then the Bast family. And the Bast couple are sort of the lower class, we are the upper class, and the Schlegels are sort of happily in the middle, who are trying to sort of build bridges between all of us. And my character doesn't understand why I would need to do that, because I'm perfectly comfortable and happy up here, so why would I need to talk to people down there? And it's sort of a way of how do we connect with people who are from vastly different backgrounds but might have the same ideas about life and values and morals. And I think that's the sort of hook, and that's why when I sort of read it, I thought, well, I've got to do this, because it's an old classic, but what Ken has done, Ken Lonergan, is he's made it extremely modern and accessible for an audience today.
What is so special about what Ken does as a screenwriter? What is unique about his work?
I would have to say the way he actually on the page in a script, how he writes, is so specific of sort of if there's an argument or a debate within, you know, within a scene, he writes the dialogue so specifically. You cut in on that word, you cut in on the T of that word, you cut in. And when you read it, you go, oh God, that's crikey, got to get my head around that. But when you do, and Hetty, the director, Hetty McDonald, said very, very clearly on the first date, we are sticking to this. Absolutely. There's no mislearnings. We're not going to just generally do, oh, everyone talk at once. And because of that, which is him, that sort of set skeleton, it feels like an absolutely realistic argument or a realistic. And he did that fantastically in Manchester by the Sea. I rewatched it when I got the part, and you see these sort of arguments between these two people, and the words are so well placed, and the wit as well. It's not a sort of waffling old period drama. He's just got this sharp wit, which sort of brings you in, and again makes it very modern, I think. So I'm the middle child. There's Charles Wilcox, who's the older brother, who is sort of trying to impress Dad, who's Henry Wilcox, Matthew McFadden. And then I'm sort of, I think I'm mummy's girl, actually. It's the only girl, the middle child. And then there's Paul Wilcox, who's the younger. Me and Paul get along very well, but it's. I think we're all sort of trying to be a bit more grown up than we actually are. And also in that time, you have to grow up quickly, because then, especially for women, you grow up, you're married, you're a wife. And so we're all sort of trying to please the adults and try to be the... be correct adults, I think, in that world. But it's a good sort of, I think the word that comes to mind is bosh. We always go, oh no, that's bosh, that's bosh. You know, there's a good sort of playfulness in it within the Wilcoxes, which I loved playing with Joe and Jonah, my brothers.
Of course, it's an amazing ensemble cast led by the beautiful Hayley Atwell. Can you talk a little bit about your experience with that, and what in particular makes Hayley such a great ensemble leader?
Oh, well, yes, ensemble leader. I mean, you have to, I think when you are playing the lead, there's a responsibility. You're not just playing the lead in the part, you're also playing the lead on the set. So you have the director and everything, but like you said, in an ensemble, you need someone who will set the tone every day. And she was so brilliant at coming in every day and brilliant energy and making everyone feel, oh, you're right, making everyone feel comfortable playing games in between, you know, the changes of setup, which again relaxes you and makes you feel comfortable and at home. And she's brilliant, and also knows how to have a laugh, and I think that's really, really key. I think if you know how to have a giggle, it's that fine line between comedy and tragedy. If you can giggle, you can then probably turn to tears, hopefully. I mean, who knows, we'll see.
Matthew McFadden and I had this ongoing kind of running joke that, you know, maybe the fact that Margaret Schlegel, my character, changes him by the end of the piece, was it always kind of a hidden attempt to just infantilize him and make him a baby? And we had this idea that he's just sat at the end of the film eating rusks in a nappy. So on his last day of filming, I went into his trailer and I put a training potty over his toilet, nappy in his trousers, a dummy in his pocket, nappy rash cream on his makeup station. And then every time he asked for a cup of tea on set, I had the runners give it to him in a sippy cup with a bib. So he got to spend the day as a big baby, which was really fun. But that's the kind of, we just like make each other laugh. It makes the day go by quicker and it's so much more enjoyable.
So I play Charles Wilcox, who is the eldest son of Henry Wilcox, played by Matthew McFadden. And our family is a very rich, capitalist, top of the business pile type family, very much serious, quite serious about everything, serious about sport and serious about business and serious about life, really. I mean, particularly my character, I think he's described as conceited and serious, and maybe has something up his, I won't say where, but he's, so they're quite a tightly knit family, but also there's maybe some difficulties between the father and the children that they don't quite know how to deal with or acknowledge. And we fit into the family. We met the Schlegels in Germany when they're on holiday before it starts, And then in the first episode, Helen Schlegel comes in to stay with us in our house in the country, Howards End. And gradually our two families become intertwined over the course of the series. Well, being a relative newcomer to it is incredibly exciting because you're there next to, I grew up watching Spooks and I've always been a huge fan of Matthew. Verging on the stalkerish. I always loved his work. So first of all, you have the awkward conversations where you're pretending not to know who he is almost. You're just trying to be normal and go, he says, I did the show called Spooks. And you go, oh, yes, I think I've heard of it. So there's that weird thing. And then, you've got Hayley as well, who I've seen in Brideshead Revisited and Captain America. And there's the immediate surrealness of it all that then gradually, as you realise how genuinely lovely they are and genuinely helpful and full of advice for younger actors like us who don't really necessarily know exactly what we're doing, it became more and more fruitful and joyful, I think. Yeah.
Do you have a fondest memory from your time making this wonderful piece of drama?
Lots of them, but probably one day when I insisted on putting on a period swimming costume. My character was meant to hold it and walk towards a pond, and I saw it and thought it was so funny that I insisted on putting it on and then sprinting, and it's now made it into the show. There's a scene of me in one of those ridiculous Victorian woolen knitted swimming, I don't know what they were doing, but wearing this completely stupid swimming costume and sprinting down to a pond, and I have to say that was just, I was in my element.
Why do you think, despite the period setting, it's a story that still feels so relevant to a contemporary audience?
Well, I'd say that the moral of it is this phrase, only connect, which is written in the beginning of the book, and Margaret says it to Henry, this is my sermon, only connect. And if it's saying anything, it's saying so many things, but the main thing to take away from it, I think, is the importance of people from different social circumstances and different backgrounds and different genders to connect and try to understand each other. And because I think right now that's a huge thing, that everyone's caught in their own bubbles and their own, on Twitter and Facebook, you see your own views reflected back to you, and then something happens. I was surprised by Trump and Brexit and things like that, and you go, oh, why did I not see that coming? It's because I'm stuck in my own little bubble, and these three families that it centres around are definitely stuck in their own bubbles, and the Schlegels branch out and try to reach out to them. So I think that's something, a message that is pretty relevant.
I am playing Jackie Bast, Leonard's wife, the working class couple. Well, they're a working class couple, and specifically Jackie, a woman of that era, is wholly reliant on her husband. She can't work for herself, so it puts them in a very difficult position where they're struggling for their survival, literally. They can't eat, and she becomes very ill. So as a direct result of the Schlegels and the Wilcoxes, predominantly the Wilcoxes, who are the upper class. Nothing much has really changed. Each class is so intertwined, and the upper class still affects the working class and the middle class. So that's why it's still relevant. And obviously Kenny's written a very modern piece of writing, although it's period drama, I think it will still be very relevant to the majority of the audience that will watch this.
Well, the story centres on three very different families, and the Schlegels are sort of this very unconventional and intellectual and quite sheltered family, and I think the difference between them is that the three families, I think the Schlegels really see the importance of bridging the gap between these families, and they want to broaden their horizons, and they want to connect with people outside of their immediate social sphere. Particularly Helen, the character I play, who is the younger of the sisters and is very impulsive and outspoken and very audacious, and she in a lot of ways is quite restless as well. I think she feels quite stifled in, as a woman in Edwardian England, and she sees the Basts, and they are sort of the perfect cause for all of her righteous idealism, and they Mr. Bast is almost like an anthropological experiment for her, and she really does mean well, but also is somewhat misguided in the way that she tries to help them. And yeah, so it's sort of how these three families become intertwined, largely thanks to Helen meddling and, you know, running about. But it really gives a great comparison of, you know, the class system in England at this time, and is just, you know, I think what's amazing about it is at the helm there are these two incredibly remarkable women, and I think that that is what makes it relevant today. I mean, both Margaret and Helen are such iconic characters, and I, you know, just think that Hayley tackled it with such grace, and she really brings such a grounded, and I think what's so amazing about Margaret is that she's so fair and so considered and incredibly empathetic, and I think Hayley really captures all of that, and she's such a generous and caring person. I mean, personally, this being my first job in the UK, she really, I think, took me under her wing and was just so lovely to work with, and I think all of her loveliness really comes through in this character, which is I think she just does an amazing job with it, and I think people are going to love her Margaret. I just hope that you know, they see this story, which is such an amazing story filmed with so many amazing characters with fresh eyes, and I hope that they are able to see just how amazing these women are at the helm of this story, and I think I hope they like it, but who knows.